Sure, man. I could tell you a lot of stuff. No problem. Where are you from originally?
We are from Colombia and our friend Cesar is from
México.
Mexico.
Oh, hola, mis amigos. Hablo un
Hola.
poquito español. Mi padre vivió en Guadalajara por 2 años, por escuela
Wow.
médico. Y sí, si hablas más despacio y claro, entiendo todo en español.
Okay, but if you got problems, don't worry, I'm here.
Thank you. Lo aprecio mucho, mi amigo.
No, we apreciamos that you are here, man, with us.
Thank you, of course. Yeah, I'm ready whenever you guys are. Hold on, just want to see. Is that bien? That's
Todo
okay.
bien, todo
todo
bien.
bien. Okay,
Awesome,
perfect.
awesome.
No, awesome, man.
Estoy listo.
Dale, John, César,
Bueno,
el que quise.
primero yo quisiera preguntarle sobre, hay un cortometraje que dirigió hace ya algunos años que te lo envié aquí al chat, Andrés, y la verdad me gustaría saber cómo fue el debut de todo y para llegar a donde está ahora.
It's been a long journey. It's been a beautiful journey overall. 15 years. I just always knew that I wanted to do film, you know. Películas es mi vida, por eternidad. En serio, you know, it's I love to do it. It's my passion. So I will never stop doing it. I just always knew I wanted to.
I
Sure.
feel sad because I haven't the time to finish Shadows, but I
Oh, that's
started,
okay.
I let it in the half, and when I start seeing it, I was like, John, you have to watch it. You have to watch it. It's a great work, man.
And you see a little bit, there's some a little bit of parts in Spanish. You see there's a
Yes,
couple lines and all that. You see that a
but
little bit.
I will translate that to my friends. John, obviamente, dice que es un viaje de 15 años, que él siempre quiso hacer películas y tuve que parar para decirle que, acuérdate que yo estaba viendo Shadows, ¿no? Yo no logré terminarla, pero acuérdate que yo te lo dije cuando empecé a verla. John, tienes que verla, tienes que verla. Y hay un detalle, si la viste, ¿no? Hay partes en español, ¿no?
Hay algunas partes que en las que él tenía muchas referencias a películas de la vieja guardia y en la actual. Me parece como increíble, o sea, cómo puede poder hacer como el Spanglish como perfecto para tu película.
Yeah, man. In fact, how do you miss those like old-fashioned style with new and the Spanglish? Tell us in the movie.
I was always influenced by films from the 80s and 90s in particular, you know, the 80s, 90s action thrillers and even 70s gangster films, you know, Godfather, Scarface, Carlito's Way, Goodfellas, Pulp Fiction, all of those. So Die Hard. I like to blend a lot of films from the past into more of a new world. But I think that unfortunately now with a lot of film stuff, there's all these remakes or they just want to make stuff that's just all political. They want to score political points. And that's not what people want to see. That's why, sorry, and I'll let you translate in a second, but that's why the Oscars now is not that popular because they don't want to hear the political stuff. Film is an escape. It's entertainment. You know, that's what it's about. So that's what I try to do.
Pues bueno, buenas noches a todos. Gracias a nuestro invitado por aceptar la entrevista. Y bueno, yo quiero preguntar por un cortometraje que se llama Turning Point, que es del 2008. Michael fue guionista y productor. Y bueno, el corto trata sobre, bueno, tenemos al protagonista que tiene depresión y eso está haciendo que se desapegue un poco de su fe, de sus creencias. Entonces tiene una discusión muy fuerte con su amigo. Y pues bueno, quisiera preguntarle si él considera que el cine puede darnos fuerzas para abrazar nuestra fe, nuestra creencia.
Resuming and turning point, the question from César, really beautiful question. Do you think that movies can let you like teach us how to hold to our force, get stronger? Because this movie talks about redemption, about you know it that you
So that
actually.
was, yeah, that was a long time ago. That was when I hace mucho tiempo. It was when I was very young. I helped out. I helped write it, but I was in college still, and I wanted to talk about life, religion, afterlife, everything like that. So I feel like films can be can teach you things. It's what you make of them. And it starts with the characters. You know, my film Shadows, the one you said you saw, that I think is my best film because the characters are so well defined. They're, you know, so yeah, I think that there's an educational aspect, but you do it in an entertaining way, you know?
Michael lo acaba de decir que obviamente entre ese corto a Shadows hay un largo camino. Y sí, César, debes verla. A mí me falta terminarla, pero la baja voz. John, ¿cuántas estrellas, Chavo? Sé honesto.
¿Del 1 al 10?
10.
8. Porque ¿8? La 2 falta, pues, para que termine más duración, porque yo quería ver más.
I am my friend. Michael, where are you? You are there?
It's okay, I'm here.
I asked John. What in how do you rate Shadows? He said that 8 because he needs a sequel.
Sí, estoy de acuerdo. Yes, there you go. Yes.
Pues bueno, yo quiero seguir con otro corto que sacó. El primero de Turning Point era del 2008. Ahora pues me voy al 2013. Un cortometraje que se llama Day Night. Solamente pude encontrar el tráiler. Es la historia de un tipo que tiene una cita con una chava, la mata y guarda el cadáver en el sótano. Al día siguiente el cadáver ya no está y el tipo está como loco buscándolo, ¿no? Este corto fue dirigido por Joe Charbanik, ¿no? Que bueno, que sabemos que él trabajó con Keanu Reeves antes. Entonces quiero preguntarle a Michael cómo surge este cortometraje y cómo llegó a trabajar con Joe.
Yeah, man. César only watched the trailer, but he wanted to see Day Night. And the question is, yes, how was working with the director that we later know that he worked also with Keanu Reeves? How was working in this movie?
Yeah, no, he was cool. You're talking about some old films, long time ago. It's a long time. But yeah, no, it was good. I was very young at the time, too. I wrote it, and the guy who starred in that film was Bill Murray's brother. Actually, Bill Murray's brother, Joel Murray, you know, so it was the star. But it was cool. It was a long time ago. It was like 2011. But it was nice. It was like a horror film. I mostly do, again, more psychological and action thrillers. But it was a good experience. And anybody that worked with Keanu Reeves is cool because I love the John Wick movies, you know, and yeah.
Bueno, yo quisiera preguntarle sobre la escena de la fiesta, porque la escena de la fiesta me recordó, exacto, pero me recordó a la mítica escena, lo que estaba hablando sobre lo de Keanu Reeves, me recordó a la película de Point Break, si no estoy mal, me hizo recordar a la escena de la fiesta. Yo dije, wow, esto es como una referencia, pero no solo eso, me gusta que hay como que un intermedio de que no resalta más ni el hombre ni la mujer, todos por igual, y me pareció importante pues que lo destaque.
No, y adivina, que justo en la escena, o sea, que lo que pasa después, sorpresa. No, okay, no. John was talking for one of my favorite scenes in Shadows. Thank goodness I watched that scene. I need to see the rest. Yes, man, yeah. The party scene. How was not only filmed, because we see like an old-fashioned action style scene. But yes. That one important thing, and yes, John, you are right. You in your movie, the women and the men
in Shadows. In Shadows.
Yes, in Shadows, about the part of yes. And that you bring to the women and the men the same importance. Like, women are not.
Oh, absolutely. Tell us. Terminator 2, for example. You know Terminator 2, of course. Amazing, right? You know, Sarah Connor is a badass woman, tough, muy fuerte, and same with Arnold, the Terminator. So, you know, entonces creo que somos iguales. And even though, like, I think that, you know, men might be physically stronger, we can have badass women. And when you keep watching Shadows, you'll see there's some tough women out there. But that was a fun scene to do, the party scene. Then we have some action. And that car that Dean drives, that was a nice car, 1971 Mustang. So classic car, beautiful, manual. So it was fun to do. And it was a quiet neighborhood, but we really had a bunch of people spill out. And thankfully, knock on wood, no cops were called or anything. So that was good.
King in the road to Crystal. I love that actress, and she did an amazing work. About Terminator 2, I don't know if you know that in this channel, we interview with Sander Berkley.
Oh, really?
Yes, man. John, comparte la Sander.
He's a cool, of course, I know. He played the foster dad in Terminator 2, and he's been in a million stuff. He's in Walking Dead, all of that. Good guy. Funny thing, little interesting thing. Me and Sander Berkley, we actually follow each other on Twitter. So we've talked a couple times. So that's cool.
When you watch the interview, tell him that you watch and you talk to John.
Of course. Seems like a very nice guy. But but yes, that party scene was very fun. And I'll say one thing. I did a little director cameo. I had a special guest thing. I was one of the people that escaped from the party. If you see it for a second, I'm in it.
I will translate
un poquito. Yeah, so it was good. It was fun.
Yo no traduciré todo, pero sí te doy la pregunta. ¿Viste el cameo de él?
¿El cameo?
¿Quién es?
¿Quién?
El que se escapa de la fiesta. Cuando empieza el tiroteo. ¿Es él?
¿Es él?
No. Claro, el de la fiesta, el que es escapado.
¿Qué te parece?
Y que él se sigue con Sander en redes. Entonces, por favor, envíale la entrevista.
Por favor, se la envío sin problema. Eso sí, con todo gusto.
Mi siguiente pregunta va de un proyecto que está en preproducción, que todavía no sale, que se llama Carisma Killer, que es sobre el mentor de 7 asesinos que tiene cáncer. Entonces, más o menos como que les deja una prueba, que es como una prueba final. Y pues bueno, quisiera que nos contara algo, a lo mejor yo sé que no nos puede decir todo, pero algo que podríamos esperar de este proyecto.
Carisma Killers va a estar mi mejor película, en serio. Okay, con the best cast ever. I know, I'm sorry to speak a little Spanish and English. Lo siento, like I tried, but estoy intentando. That one, it's about a group of, 7 killers. They all have unique ways of killing. And the mentor who basically keeps them all out of jail, he finds out again, he has cancer, and he gives them all this one mission to go out and do this job. Before he dies. So very intense action. And we just had a table read. I don't know if you see on my social media post, we had a table read where we all read the script out loud. And it was amazing. And we have some good people, Vernon Wells, who's Mad Max Road Warrior and Commando, con Arnold Schwarzenegger. And in Shadows, yes. And we have a bunch of others. Vanessa Angel was in that movie Kingpin, that comedy, the bowling movie with Woody Harrelson and Bill Murray, if you remember. But it's fun. So in October,
I had to do one favor to my friend John because he loves wrestling. How was directing Solo Fafato Jr.?
Oh, Rikishi.
Yes, Rikishi is in that movie, John. Rikishi está en esa película.
Rikishi.
Venga para acá, por favor. Acá tuvimos a Eric Watts.
Yes, we got Eric Watts and Sabu here. But, and of course, Magalactic, but man, John loves Rikishi. How was
Rikishi and also two female wrestlers as well. In WWE, known as the Iconics. You could look them up. Her name's Jessica McKay. What you look up Jessica McKay. Yeah. And also that Tennille Dashwood, you could look her up. And then Brian Pillman Jr., the son of Brian Pillman, the Hart Foundation. Remember? ¿Recuerdas? Like Hart Foundation, Bret Hart, Owen Hart, British Bulldog, Brian Pillman, his son is in it too. So we have cuatro luchadores,
John, ya puedes,
or wrestlers. I don't know if that's how you say it.
Luchadores, yes. Like in Mexico, luchadores.
Okay, I don't know how to say wrestlers in Spanish. Yeah. I thought luchadores, but we have four. Yeah.
John, puedes morir en paz. Habla.
Man, yo te quiero preguntar algo. ¿Alguna vez en el canal, aparte de estará Vernon Wells aquí, o estará también está un Simon Panda? Chuck Conley,
yeah.
Ven, alguna vez estarán en el canal, hasta Tyra de Maino, que yo he visto las reacciones de YouTube, ven.
John said that he saw that somebody from that amazing cast be in the channel. You heard the names.
No, and Simian Panda's done a lot too. I don't know if, did you get to the part in Shadows where that one businesswoman is speaking in Spanish, or did you not get to that part yet?
¿Te acuerdas la parte en Chavos de la mujer de un negocio?
Businesswoman speaking in Spanish, yeah.
Y todos están reunidos.
Sí, la reunión, todos.
Ajá.
Sí, Johnson.
Her name is Eva Martinez, Eva Martinez, and she actually has done, she's from Mexico, and she's done a lot of films in Mexico.
César, ¿la
Eva
conoces?
Martinez, she's done a lot of films. She goes, works in Mexico all the time.
¿No conoces a Eva, John, César?
Eva
Eva Martínez.
Martinez, yeah.
I tell the name to my friend César. César, Sergio
She's
César.
in, yeah, so she's done a lot, but she lives in Orange County part and then in Mexico other part of her time. She splits time. Yeah. So it's interesante.
Obvio, muy interesante. Bueno, sí, John, César, ¿quién sigue? ¿Cómo vamos?
Bueno, yo seguí.
Emocionado.
Sí, yo también estoy emocionado. Los datos que está diciendo, increíble. Ven, también yo quería preguntarte sobre un caso, pero eso sí, yo digo, no solo el proceso. En The Chasemen, uff, eso sí es una joya. Solo quiero decir cómo es el plan para poder hacer que el protagonista tenga como los elementos que, o sea, que uno quisiera tener con el presupuesto que tiene.
And man, that's a
Sí.
great question. How do you manage being a producer, getting, because we know that you work with a limited budget, how do you get to do something like The Chase or Child that looks great, that make every penny worth? Tell us.
Yeah, I'm very lucky, thankfully. I have a lot of I'm born and raised in LA and most of the in Los Angeles, and most of the films that I do are all in Los Angeles. So thankfully, I know people, so we can get some locations for free, or we get it at reduced rates and all of that. But I think that the actors, you know, you send them the script and they really like the character, and then some of them will do it for cheaper than you may think. So I've gotten very lucky, I would say that. You know, very lucky, muy suerte. Sí. So that's what I would say. And with Shadows, it was 25-day shoot. Chase was 18-day shoot, and Charisma Killers will be 20-day shoot.
Bueno, yo es que lo más importante es que, no, pues es un dato curioso, ¿no? Es que Quest Jessica aparece en The Chainmen y yo a Quest Jessica lo conozco por López, pero él también estaba en La Deuda 2, dirigido por Jesse B. Johnson. Entonces yo digo que ahí vea la línea cronológica sobre todo. Y hombre, yo sí quisiera preguntarle cuál película le hace falta más completar su carrera, que diga el Big Dream.
I know that's a great question from John. I know that you made Shadows. I know that you know, we know that the Charisma Killers will be your best work. But man, that is like a dream project, or like you say, oh, but I need to do this kind of movie. You can tell us.
I would love to do an epic crime thriller like Casino or Goodfellas. I would, or even a little bit like The Irishman. Like, I know they're long, but those like 3-hour epics that just over a period of time tell the life of a gangster or some crime person or something like that. I really like that. Or even a film like, do you know that Brazilian film City of God? Have you heard of it? City of God, of course. Yeah, City of God. And then there's that other Brazilian film, Elite Troops, Tropa de Elite, or something like that. Yeah, you know, those films are amazing. Actually, also, and I only saw the first two seasons, but I should see the Mexican Narcos that season. But I saw the first two seasons of Narcos, you know, the part that shows Escobar. Loved it. Loved it. All of that stuff. It's funny. I say this real quick. I do a lot of films that have to do with drugs and stuff like that. but I'm completely clean. I'm straight edged. I don't even really drink. So it's funny that way. I don't know. That world fascinates me, though.
In this channel, John got the loot. I don't participate there, but I was listening to interview Karen Lasso from Narcos. We need not only show you that, but I don't know. You guys know it, John. Necesitamos que Karen Lasso y Michael, porque él le encanta Narcos. Y tú sabes, Karen Lasso, el papelazo que se hizo, ¿no? Ahí haz la magia, John, haz tu magia. Preséntalos. John, o a César.
Yo se lo hago contestar, yo se lo hago llegar sin problema. Yo sí te quiero, pues, felicitar por no solo Shadows, Chase, está misógino. Pero eso sí abarca el tema mucho de mansplaining. Bueno, un tema muy polémico en algunos países, pero yo quiero preguntarte sobre lo importante que es hacer que no solo el hombre, sino tanto la mujer, es el único filme que yo he visto que respeta mucho los estándares. O sea, cómo cumplió ese objetivo, que por lo tanto siempre hay contrariedad en eso.
Yes, no, because John watched the misogyny, from nowhere.
Gritty, like it's very dark, very disturbing, muy incómodo. I can't believe that was my first feature film. It's very, that film polarized people. You either appreciated what I was trying to do to tell this dark story, or some people hated it and said it was too mean-spirited, too messed up, all of that. We shot that in 7 days. That's it. Siete días. Like, it was crazy, you know? But I learned a lot from it. I learned a lot. And you see, after Misogynist with Chase, with Shadows, I get better. I'm improving. I'm improving as a filmmaker. Acting, story-wise, todo.
With some popcorns y palomitas, Shadows, because I was enjoying it. Aplausos.
Thank you.
Aplausos. Bravo.
Thank you. Gracias. Muchas gracias. Keep finish Shadows because it does not disappoint. Believe me, it does not let you down. You will enjoy it. You watch the whole thing, you will like it a lot. Seriously. Te prometo.
Oh, I know, man. Redes sociales, sí.
Sí, por
favor. John, Mateo, sorry.
Yes,
you got the camera to tell your social media so people can follow you, send a big hi to the channel, to Colombia.
Sure.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I'm on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. I go by my full name, so just Michael Mateo Rossi. Mateo con two T's. I know in the Latin world it's one T, but I'm Italian, so two T's, and Rossi. So Michael Mateo Rossi, if you just search me on Instagram, Twitter, or Facebook, I'm on there. I try to respond to messages. I probably use Twitter and Twitter and Instagram the most, but you say hello, so that's where people can find me.
Sí, por favor, pasen el chat.
No, César, claro que buena, sí. Está buena, créeme que I'm telling my friend that.
Yeah.
John, share to César Chados. We need to finish it.
So, yes, finish it. And your friend likes wrestling, right? Likes wrestling?
John loves wrestling.
No, man.
Okay,
no.
Wait. He'll find this funny. He'll find this funny. Let me tell you some of the wrestlers that follow me, that we follow each other. And you can tell them on Twitter, a lot follow me and I follow them. You ready? Isdo, you want to know?
Yes, go ahead.
So Kurt Angle, Paul Heyman, Lita, John Cena. Hold on. A whole bunch of other ones that I can't think. Like some big people follow me, but those are probably some of the biggest.
So I forget, the Amazing Alburgo was here on the channel.
Yeah, I know, exactly, right? Yeah, wow. No, that's crazy. Wow. But yeah, no, a lot follow me and it's pretty cool, you know?
John, es que ellos lo siguen en redes.
Oh, por favor.
Bueno,
por supuesto, no. Conmigo. Gracias. No, primero, agradecerle a Charlie por la oportunidad, que obviamente, Charlie, le agradecemos, Mayner, que dice, y hombre, bienvenido siempre. Cuando quiera, esta es tu casa.
First, thanks to Charlie at Midnight Releasing and to Man, this is your house. Whatever you want, go ahead.
Thank you. Lo aprecio mucho. Thank you. You guys have been very awesome, and I appreciate you taking the time. And please, like, feel free to tag me on stuff. Let me know. Send the email. I can maybe email you my links again so you see. But I and you know what? En el futuro quiero filmar en México y Colombia y otros países. Mucho. Y quiero visitar. Quiero visitar Colombia. También. Yes,
you want to
yes.
go to the Hacienda Nápoles?
What? I'd love to film it just, and go wherever. I mean, that would be awesome.
No, you it's great because Hacienda Nápoles now is like an hotel from the sí. victims. So it's a project that helps the victims from, you know, the narcotraffic.
Of course. He visitado México, pero principalmente el norte, Baja, pero me gustó mucho.
La Ciudad de México, ¿no?
Supongo. Sí. No, sí. no, no, solo, sí. solamente el norte, like Baja.
Monterrey, así, ¿no?
Pero, like, Mazatlán también. Mazatlán. Sí, oh. y Puerto Vallarta. Pero I really want to go to this one place, maybe you know it, called Tulum en Yucatán. ¿Conoces?
Tulum, sí.
Este, ok. I just see the pictures con la playa.
Y está hermoso.
It's just, it looks amazing.
And es un lugar say, muy hermoso.
Sí.
But I will translate the part.
Quiero visitar mucho.
And as I finish, I will translate the part that you tell me that you show drugs in your movies, but you are clean. So,
yes, say that, please.
Él me pidió ese favor y qué pena hacer esto, que a pesar de que él muestra muchas drogas en sus películas, nada, limpio.
Sí, eso es lo importante.
Gracias. Gracias.
Muchas gracias por la oportunidad. Estamos, mire, agradecidos y
muchas gracias.
Siempre bienvenido.
De nada, mis amigos, de nada. You know, and let's do this anytime. Reach out anytime. We can talk, and maybe one time you guys even visit set when I'm filming. That'd be nice.
Que cualquier tiempo lo hagan, que obviamente cuando tengamos la posibilidad que lo visitemos en el set, que John del Tepol va a compartir los links, o voy a compartir el de Sander, a los de los luchadores, y hace el milagro, el menos conozca a Karel.
Sí. Dios se lo haga. Muchas gracias.
Thank you, guys.
Bye,
guys.
Bye.
Gracias. Let's talk gracias. Soon, okay? Hasta okay. pronto, mis amigos.
And the best recording, man. Because you know, we know that you are recording, so good luck.
Perfect. That's perfect. Thank
bye,
you.
Bye.
Hasta pronto.